And I'm back with Richard Ford talking about his novel, Canada. I read that you started this novel 20 years ago and stopped.
I did.
But it stayed with you, clearly.
Yes, it stayed with me, not in the form that I began it. I wrote 20 pages in 1989 and then, for circumstantial reasons, didn't keep on writing. Stuck those pages in the freezer of my house, in my house where we live.
In the freezer of your house?
Yes. That way I would always know where it was. I mean, I come from Depression-era family where parents lived in old, dry, wooden houses in northwest Arkansas. And my mother was always growing up afraid the house would burn. Uh-huh. So the one place that they could put things
was
in the refrigerator. And in our house, I'm not so afraid that the house will burn, but I'm afraid the dogs will get it, or the cats will get it, or something will happen to it. So I stick stuff in the refrigerator. Anyway, I did that, stuck it in the refrigerator, and forgot about it, basically. Mm-hmm. Forgot about what was in those pages. But I would make notes periodically about what I remembered the book or the story was about. And then I would stuff those notes into an envelope where my early pages were. And by the time 22 years went by, I had a really fat notebook full of notes. Mm-hmm. And so from those notes, I wrote the book that is now called Canada.
You're a writer who doesn't write a whole lot. Or you take years to write books,
yes.
Right?
Yes.
Because?
Because I think that's the best way I can get the most out of myself. I mean, if I wrote a book a year, well, I couldn't write a book a year. Mm. But if I tried to write a book a year, it wouldn't be any good. Mm. I'm just a slow thinker. I'm a slow reader. I do everything pretty slowly. And fortunately, I've lived with somebody all these years who likes to work. And so when I haven't been able to make any money, Christina has had a job, which abets my slowness in a way. Uh-huh. I mean, she said to me when we were kids, she said, now look, it's a great idea for you to be a novelist. She said, so I'll go get a job and you stay home and write. So we're just living out that
bargain.
You
made the deal early on
made
and
it
stuck.
In 1966.
And in these years where you're writing, is it just writing from beginning to end?
Yes,
or
it is.
It is.
Yeah. So I never jump to the end of something and write it. I think writing the end of a book is a great moment in a writer's life. And so I don't want to get ahead of myself. I don't want to give myself that pleasure until it is the real thing, until I can actually say, this ending that I'm writing is fueled by and is the sum of all of these things that I have been thinking about for the last 2 or 3 years.
Let me ask you one more thing, and I like to talk to a lot of writers about this. It's just the big question, you know, the state of reading, the state of writing, the state of literature. You're just finishing a book tour. You've been all over the place, and I know you've been in Australia as well as you've been out of the country, and talking to people who love books, clearly.
Yes.
Right? But what do you see more generally? Are you sanguine about the state of writing and reading today?
Yes.
You are?
Yes. I'm very sanguine about writing because I see, in America particularly, which is what I know the best, I see wonderful writing going on in America. I see a generation of writers who are better than my generation of writers, both the generation that's 20 years younger than I am and the generation that's 20, you know, that's 40 years younger than I am, mm-hmm. basically. They're wonderful writers. I see readers wanting to read these books. I see books like mine, a literary book on the bestseller list. I see all the time a book like Jennifer Egan's book on the bestseller list, Jeffrey Eugenides' books on the bestseller list. That gives me hope to think that people will be reading serious novels into the future. Books are a different matter, mm-hmm. I think. The book like my
book. The physical form.
It's a delivery system of a quite wonderful kind, but it's going to give way and is giving way to the forces of the marketplace, I think. It's not that people don't love that book. They do love that book. But people want to make them more cheaply and they want to disseminate them more broadly. And that book will become, I think, before too terribly long, probably in my lifetime, antiquarian's business. I'm sorry. I hate to be the deliverer of news like that, but I've been delivering that news for 20 years and it's
getting more and more true.
Creakingly come along to be true. Yeah.
All right, Richard Ford, nice to talk to you.
You're welcome. Thank you, Jeff.